He was on his way home from kennel top. Been 2 weeks gone and he thought he'd stop at Webb's and have him a drink before he went home to her. And he Wolo said hello. He said, "Hi, what's doing?" Wolo said, "Sit down, I got some bad news, gonna hurt." Said, "I'm your best friend and you know that's right, but your young bride ain't home tonight since you've been gone. She's been seeing that Amos boy Seth." Now he got mad and he saw red, and he said, "Boy, don't you lose your head, 'cause I tell you the truth, I've been with her myself." And he got scared and left the bar, walking on home 'cause he didn't live far, you see. And he didn't have many friends and just lost them one. Brother thought his wife must have left town, so he went home and finally found the only thing that he left him, and that was a gun. He went off to Andy's house, slipping through the backwoods quiet as a mouse. Came upon some tracks too small for at the back porch door, and he saw Andy lying on the floor in a puddle of blood, and he started to shake. Georgia Patrol was making the run, so he fired a shot just to flag him down. A big Billy sheriff got his gun and said, "Why'd you do it?" The judge said, "Guilty on the make-believe trial." Slapped the sheriff on the back with a smile and said, "Supper's waiting at home. That's a night that the lights went out in Georgia. That's a night that they hug an innocent man. Well, don't trust your soul and don't backward Southern blood, 'cause the judge of the town's got bloodstains on his head." Well, they hung my brother before I could say the tracks they saw